Khonius here. Tonight I thought it would be fun to take the Volocity air taxi out for a ride over my area. I'm flying from Concord, Buchanan Field. I live in Pittsburg, California, so I'll be flying in that direction. It's a beautiful, clear, starry night. I have it set to live weather, so I guess the weather must really be this nice out if I looked out the window. Inside. I don't think there's any kind of a parking brake. Go ahead and take off. It's usually better to fly from the outside. Let's see, you get such a nice view that it can head off in that direction. Nice to be able to see the runway light patterns. I wouldn't actually see this many stars. The Bay Area weather is never clear enough to see the stars like that. But it's really pretty in the game. Let's see if I can find. Yeah, there's the Redden movie theater down there. No movie show. Yeah, I was really curious to see what this thing was like at night. It doesn't fly any different, of course. I thought the visuals would be kind of interesting. I'm going to drop down. This is the freeway interchange I go through to get home. Highway 4. See a lot of red lights on the horizon in the distance. I think those are all the windmills, electric generation windmills. The street looks very lit up with orange, I guess sodium vapor light, and orange paint. Mostly looks familiar from driving this way so many times, but not precisely. The hill seems very active. The freeway should actually have more lanes showing though, I think it's got more lanes. Yeah, I didn't realize how twisted around there was, but the momentum's still carrying us forward. This thing has a lot of versatility. It's like flying a drone. You can sort of maneuver it anywhere you want, any direction you want. Turn around and go backwards, whatever. It's really easy to fly. I think this might be the future of personal aviation, being able to fly something like this. Seems like the average person could pick it up. A combination of that with good AI and autonomous capabilities, this could be good for anybody to fly. Just some safety features. Not intended for personal use, it's intended for short trips because the batteries don't only last for a half an hour or so. And then you swap them out for a new set. In the game I'm set to unlimited fuel, but that doesn't seem to apply because they do run out and then the thing falls out of the sky like that. But really interesting to see how this all looks at night. Again, it's so funny being able to see the Milky Way up there because in the Bay Area you just can't see it. Too much light pollution. interesting the way the throttle works. You know, if I move the lever up, it doesn't increase thrust. What it does is it temporarily increases thrust, and then it will push me up. So I'll do that, temporarily increases thrust. So I can lift it up. Now if I keep it all the way up, it will continuously try to ascend forward, or ascend up. But if I pull back, it'll just temporarily drop, and then go back to the same speed. Oh, I have to acknowledge because it's a co-pilot. Sorry.
Onboard tower KA540 frequency change.
So it makes loading the throttle a little interesting, but it becomes intuitive. You know, if I know I want to drop, I just drop the throttle down. I'm happy with the level I'm at, I can stay there. If I go too low, it will start descending, so I feel like it's a combination of the timed speed-ups and slowdowns, and then when you get towards the edges of the range, it will either continuously ascend or descend, some combination, some, you know, computer-controlled combination of those two is what feels like. Passing the shopping center, I need to get my groceries out. I feel like I'm a little low, so let's pump up. You have to go past the 50% point in the throttle, and then it will do a lift. Just a moment. So you can actually find a stable hover level, and then fly at that level, which is nice. Who knows how realistic this is compared to the actual craft, but it seems like the simulation craft is sponsored by the manufacturer. They show it on their website to demonstrate the vehicle, so I think it's probably close enough. I see some kind of a lit green field over there, like a football field or something, but the kind of field over there. And it does seem that I can push the throttle forward and then push the stick forward and I can get some extra acceleration going. See if I can get up to about 70. Maybe not quite 70. I think if I maybe drop a little bit, turn some of that into forward. I have managed to get up to 70. Okay, it doesn't look like a field here, it just looks like trees and tree lights. Some very red street lights on the freeway for some reason. Well, I do see a baseball bat. Actually, a couple of them. Maybe several right at the park. Some other kind of a baseball bat in there. Maybe a school. I really do enjoy flying this thing because of the ability to hover and, you know, look at things close up slowly, like a helicopter. There is a helicopter available, but I'd rather wait until the game has official support for helicopters before I actually pay for an aircraft. So I can drop the throttle down. I'm now below the 50% point, and so we're slowly dropping. See, if I go up to 50%, it might just start hovering. Let's not dropping. I'm not sure. I have to go slightly above 50% to get it to... Yeah, got it to go up a little bit. So I can usually find a stable hover point. So just going along. Okay, now we're going to 70. I'm going along at freeway speeds. To direct my momentum over towards this way I want to go. I think we need some more altitude here. And then I'm trying not to get too high. I don't know if I've spotted my exit on the freeway yet. I don't think I've passed it yet. Yeah, that's something else. I'm not sure what that is. That's definitely closer. Hard to navigate by sight tonight. I think I might still be heading in the right direction. See if I can get a little closer to the freeway. Doesn't really look like that in real life with all those extra turns. Extra lane turns. These funny lights out in the middle of space. I don't know what that's all about. Rather odd. The freeway kind of looks like it's under construction. I guess those are just, you know, glowing streetlight orbs or something. I'm trying to see if I can find my exit. but just gonna tell where I'm at. I think I might have gone too far. Well, let's see, if I look around behind me. If I let off the throttle a little bit, it signal it that I want to go forward as opposed to going up. Baseball diamond at one point, but dilapidated. Should probably check what the battery levels are doing. A little around less than 50% in some cases. Well, I'm going to end it right there. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.